This video is on the topic of blood vessels. Firstly, let's name the three main types of blood vessels you need to be aware of. They are arteries, veins, and capillaries. You do need to make sure that you know about the structure of each of these vessels, so let's go through them now. All arteries other than the pulmonary artery carry oxygenated blood away from the heart to all the major organs in the body. They have a thick wall made of muscle and elastic fibres to withstand the high pressure of the blood inside. The lumen, which is the hollow part of blood vessels, has a narrow diameter. You only need to describe the structure of each vessel. You do not need to explain it unless you are doing the extended syllabus content. All veins, apart from the pulmonary vein, are responsible for carrying deoxygenated blood back to the heart from the body cells. Blood is at a lower pressure here than in the arteries because it has travelled a long way since it was last pumped by the heart muscle. Veins also have a muscular wall, but it is much thinner than in arteries. Their lumen has a much larger diameter. In addition to these structures, veins also have valves present. This is to stop the backflow of blood, which is more likely in veins due to the low pressure of the blood inside. In an exam, you may be given images of arteries and veins and asked to identify them or compare their structures. Capillaries are the smallest of the three blood vessels and carry both oxygenated and deoxygenated blood, depending on where they are within a tissue. They have walls that are one cell thick and are said to leak, which helps the formation of tissue fluid. In comparison to arteries and veins, they have no muscle or elastic tissue. Their lumen is very narrow and only allows for one red blood cell to squeeze through at a time, allowing diffusion to occur. They have very thin walls also, which helps diffusion to be as efficient as possible due to the short diffusion pathway. Their function is to deliver oxygen and other nutrients to the respiring cells and to collect and remove carbon dioxide and other waste products from these cells. You do need to know about the functions of the capillaries as well as their structure. Let's take a look at an exam style question. Here you can see a cross section of three blood vessels labelled X, Y, and Z. You are asked to state which vessel is used to carry blood into the right atrium of the heart and then explain your answer. This is a challenging question as you are required to apply your knowledge of blood vessels to the structure of the heart. Examiners will often combine topics such as blood vessels with blood, the heart, and circulation in exam questions. For part A, we need to first remind ourselves what type of blood vessels enter and leave the heart. The acronym VEAL here is really helpful. Veins enter, arteries leave. So the vessel must be a vein. Now we need to work out from the diagram which is the vein. We can see that Y is only one cell thick, so this should immediately jump out to you as a capillary. Between X and Y, we can see that they have similar structures, but X has a much smaller lumen and thicker walls than Z. This is a good indication that X is an artery and Z is a vein. So the answer to part A is Z for one mark. Now on to part B and explaining our answer. So we can say that the vessels that enter the heart are veins for one mark. And we can also say that Z is a vein because it has a larger lumen and thinner walls. This would be your second mark. In summary, arteries have very thick muscular walls and a narrow lumen to carry oxygenated blood at high pressures. Veins have thinner walls and a wider lumen than arteries. They also contain valves throughout their length to transport deoxygenated blood at low pressure. Capillaries are the smallest of all the vessels and have a wall that is only one cell thick. They have very narrow lumen, and these features allow them to carry out diffusion at the respiring cells within the lungs. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources. Here, save my exams.